the young prince lived in a shining castle.
But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold.
Repulsed by a haggard appearance, the prince made up the gift and sent the old woman away.
But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within.
And when he dismissed him again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for he had seen that there was no love in the prince's heart.
As coachman, she turned both to him and said,
offered him was truly an enchanted rose which would bloom for many years.
If he could learn to love another and earn her love in return, by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken.
If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time.
As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope.
For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Yeah.
kill a beast alive stands a chance against you and no girl for that matter.
It's true, but from what I got my sights set on that one.
The inventor's daughter?
She's the lucky girl I'm going to marry.
But she's
the most beautiful girl in town.
I know, but...
I don't know. She's gorgeous and I found. Here in town there's only she, who's beautiful as me. So I'm making plans to woo and marry Belle.
Look there, he goes, isn't he dreaming? With your yes, son, oh he's so cute. He's still my heart, I'm hardly breathing.
Well, it's about time you got your head out of these books and start paying attention to more important things.
Like you, Gaston, please. I have to get inside to help my father.
That crazy old fool, he needs all the help he can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yeah, don't talk about her father that way.
My father's not crazy. He's a genius.
Ha ha!
Packing them. Now let me see, where did he put the dog-legged blanket?
Papa.
Oh, thank you, dear. Did you have a good time in town tonight?
I got a new book.
You do love those books.
Papa, do you think I'm odd?
My daughter odd? Where do you get an idea like that?
I don't know. It's just, I'm not sure I fit in here. There's no one I can really talk to.
What about Gaston? He's a handsome fellow.
He's handsome, all right. And rude and conceited and... Oh, Papa, he's not for me.
Well, don't you worry, because this invention's going to be a start of a whole new life for us.
It works!
It does. It does!
Oh, Papa, you did it. You really did it. Here, I made you a scarf for good luck at the fair.
Now I know I'll win. Then we can get out of this town and go to all those places you read about in your book.
Goodbye, Papa.
Bye-bye, Belle.
Be careful.
Way to the fair to show off his new invention, Maurice entered a dark forest.
Let me see, this way or this way? Oh dear!
Let me in.
My mind, the woods are mainly the place to stay.
Poor fellow. All consorts have a heart. Miss George, you are welcome here.
Ah! And goodbye.
Wait, wait, you're talking, you're talking.
Lisa, he's stupid, I say.
And I'm super rude, it's just I never seen him.
Achoo!
You're chilled to the bone, Miss Dior. Come warm yourself by the fire.
Not the master's chant. I'm not seeing this. I'm not seeing this.
Ooh la la, what have we got here? My eyes
deceiving,
or is this a
mess? Oh, well,
hello. All right, this has gone far enough.
Coming through.
Yes, please.
Ah!
I think I scared him, Mama.
Hey there, little fellow, what's your name?
Chip.
This has gone far enough. Do you have any idea what the master will do if he finds out we let a stranger in?
Calm yourself, Cogsworth. The master will never have to know.
There's a stranger here?
Master, allow me to explain.
Who let him in?
Mr. May, take this opportunity to say, I was against it from the start.
You have all betrayed me.
Oh dear.
Who are you?
I'm Maurice.
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the woods and need this place to stay for the night.
You're not welcome here.
Yeah, I'll just stay on my way.
It's hideous, isn't it? You come to stare at the beast, haven't you?
No, I mean no harm. I was merely looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay.
For you, mademoiselle.
Oh, Gaston, you shouldn't have.
Don't mention it, Belle. Today is the day your dreams come true.
What could you possibly know about my dreams?
Picture this, a rustic hunting lodge, the strapping boys playing on the floor with my little wife massaging my feet. We'll have 6 or 7.
Dogs?
No, boys.
Imagine that.
So, Belle, what'll it be?
I just don't deserve you.
Well, who does?
But thanks for asking.
So how'd it go?
You know that, Belle. Always playing hard to get.
She turned you down?
For now, but I will have Belle as my wife and make no mistake.
Gaston, can't you just see it? That I'm Gaston, if it's a wife. No, sir.
Gaston.
You just missed him.
Wait a minute, where did you get that scarf?
Oh, this? At the crossroads. Pretty nice, huh?
It belongs to my father. Something must have happened to him.
Well, finders keepers.
Oh, Papa!
Oh, I'm going to keep quiet because I've been here to stay.
I was trying to be hospitable.
Rubbish!
Cogsworth, can you blame me for trying to maintain what's left of our humanity?
Look at us! Look at you!
What about me? Oh, right. If the master doesn't break the spell,
Slowly, but surely, we will all become things.
Hold on, Lumiere. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello?
It's a girl!
This is the one we have been waiting for. She's come to break the spell.
Let's not be hasty.
Hello? Is anyone here? Please, I'm looking for my father.
Well, is that you?
Papa!
How did you find me here?
Your hands are like ice. Who has done this to you?
But you must leave this place.
I won't leave you here. Who's there? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Well then, you're the one who's responsible for this. Release my father at once.
I do not take orders from anyone. Get out.
No, wait. Forgive me. Please let him out. Can't you see he's not well?
Then you shouldn't have trespassed here.
But he's an old man. He could die.
There's nothing you can do.
Wait, please. Take me instead.
No, Belle.
You would do that? You would take his place?
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes, but you must promise to stay here forever.
No!
Come into the light.
Belle, I'm old. I live my life.
You have my word.
Done. Take him to the village.
Wait! No, not yet!
Belle, let go of her. Belle!
Papa! Oh, I'll never get to see him again. And I didn't even get to say goodbye.
Master, since this girl is going to be with us for quite some time, you might want to offer her a more comfortable room.
I'll show you to your room. You follow me.
Yes, I made the choice. For Papa, I will stay. But I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way, you monster. If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool. Think again. Is this home? Is this where I should learn to be happy?
Where the heart is, never a word so true.
to make the world seem a bit brighter.
But you're
Mrs. Potts, dear, very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Oh, careful, darling.
Who are you?
Madame de la Grande Bouche.
Wait, this is impossible.
Well now, what shall we dress you in for dinner? Let's see what I got in my drawers.
That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
Well, of course you are. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. I'm sorry, this is just happening so fast.
That was a very brief thing you did, my dear.
We all think so.
I'm just going to miss my papa so much.
Cheer up, child. I know things might seem right now, but you mustn't despair. We're here to see you
Thank you.
Maurice?
Help, he's got her. He's got her locked in a dungeon. Belle, we must go on. It's not a minute to lose.
Wait, who has Belle locked in a dungeon?
At least a horrible, terrible beast. Fine then, I'll go back there and get her out myself.
Crazy old Maurice. Crazy old Maurice. Look, I'm afraid I've been thinking.
A dangerous pastime?
I know. Wacky old Coop is Belle's father, and sanity's only so-so. Now the wheels in my head have been turning since I looked at that gloomy old man. See, I promised myself I'd be mad, and right now I'm evolving a plan. If I...
Yes.
Then me.
No, would she?
Yes.
Now I get it.
Let's go! No! I guess Don takes deep shots. I guess Don plans to burst a few hearts.
So it's Mary who sings to me, saying
I'm playing. My, what a guy! Yes,
dinner. Where is she?
I'll go check it out. Won't be a minute.
Try to be patient, sir. The girl has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Master, perhaps, have you thought that this girl could be the one to break the spell?
Of course I have. I'm not a fool.
Good. So you fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof! The spell is broken. We'll be human again by midnight.
Lumiere, it's not that easy. These things take time.
But we don't have time. The world has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She's so beautiful and I'm... Well, look at me. Master, you must help her see past all that. I don't know how.
Well, you could start by making yourself a little bit more presentable. Impress her with your vapier wit.
But be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere.
And above all...
What?
You must control your temper!
Well, where is she?
She's not coming.
What did you say?
She's not coming.
We'll see about that.
Your lordship, your grace, your eminence, let's not be hasty.
I thought I told you to come to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of this castle, and I'm telling you to come to dinner.
Master, that may not be the best way to win the girl's affections.
Please attempt to be a gentleman.
Deep breath, master, deep breath. I'll give her one last chance. Would you be so kind to join me for dinner?
Please.
No, thank you.
Fine, then starve.
Master, please!
If she doesn't eat with me, then she doesn't eat at all.
What were we thinking? We'll never be human again.
Well, what would you have us do? Give up? I like this girl. I like her spunk.
Well, if you ask me, she was just being stubborn. After all, he did say please.
I think that's the first time I ever heard him use that word. Hello, dearie. I hope the master didn't frighten you too much. He could be a little temperamental.
A little?
I'm Cosmer, head of the household, and this is Lumiere.
Enchanté, mademoiselle.
If there is anything we could do to make you stay more comfortable, anything, anything at all.
I'm a little hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth.
Well, you heard the master said.
Oh, pish-posh. I'm not going to let this poor child go hungry.
Fine. Glass of water, crust of bread, and then...
Cogsworth, she's not our prisoner. She's our guest. We must make her feel welcome here.
Fine. Dinner. But keep it down. If the master finds out, it'll be our next.
Of course, of course. But what if dinner was a little music?
Music? My dear mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax, let us pose the chair, as the dining room proudly presents your dinner.
Be our guest, put our service to the test. Tie a napkin round your neck, sherry, and we'll provide the rest. Soup to jar, hot hors d'oeuvres, why we only live to serve. Try the great stuff.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me? Ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, this is France. And the dinner here is never second best.
A good gentleman. I'm nothing but a fool.
Okay.
And that's how the disaster was averted.
What's over there?
Nothing!
Nothing of any interest in the West Wing.
Ah, so that's the West Wing. Nice going.
Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something over here. We have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back.
Your temper. Now hold still, this may sting a little. By the way, thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome. Well, that's more like it. I knew they could get along if they tried.
So the ice is broken at last.
And not a moment too soon, the roses leaving petals at an alarming rate.
And I could hardly bend over at all anymore.
Clearly, it's time for us to give them a little push.
And I have just the thing. How about I warm you two up a bit with a nice bowl of soup?
There's something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. But now he's dear and so unsure, I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
I thought I saw, and when we touched, you didn't shudder at my fall. No, it can't be, I'll just ignore. But then she's never looked at me that way before. When she smiles at me, I get all choked up. My heart starts pounding, and I can't breathe.
Good.
That's good.
Excellent.
I want to give her something, but what?
It has to be something special, something that sparks her joy.
Who's back?
Say something
about her hair?
It's brown.
A compliment!
Oh, what a nice bow.
Thank you.
Well, I have to show you something. But first, you have to close your eyes. It's a surprise.
Should cause several husbands to
smell of wine for a change.
Really, that would be strange.
Can I hop it if I'm tent? My new shack by the sea, I'll sleep back to mean tea. Let my early retirement commence. But the fool's made of wax, all gets down to brass tacks and relax when I hear it.
When Guinevere heard that Arthur was slain, she stole away to a convent and no one could ever make her smile again. That's the end.
What a beautiful story.
I knew you'd like it. I'd like to ask you for something.
What?
A second chance. Would you like to have dinner with me tonight?
Dinner? Me? With you? Bevy? Oh, yes!
You can do it, Master. I know you can.
Sun.
Poppy here?
Oh yes, everyone's so kind. Mrs. Potts, Lumiere.
With me?
Yes.
I must speak from
the heart!
Is something wrong?
I was just thinking about my father. I miss him so much. I wish there was a way I could see him again.
There is a way. Miss Mia, I'll show you anything you wish to see.
I'd like to see my father, please. Papa? Oh no, Papa, something's wrong. He's in the woods. I think he's lost. I should...
Go to him.
What?
You should go to him.
But what about...
You are not my prisoner, Belle. You haven't been for a long time. Take this mirror so you'll always have a way to look back and remember me.
I can never forget you.
Belle, I...
Yes?
Go. I'll never see her again.
Well, everything is going swimmingly. I knew you had it, didn't you?
I let her go.
You what?
How would you do that?
I had to.
But why?
Finally, he's learned to love.
That's it then. That should break the spell.
It's not enough. She has to love him in return.
It's too late.
Terrible. In the beginning, I was so frightened. I thought it was the end of everything. But then somehow things changed.
Good afternoon.
Monsieur Dark.
I've come to collect your father.
What?
Don't worry. We'll take good care of him.
My father's not crazy. He was raving like a lunatic. We all saw him, didn't we?
Poor Belle. It's a shame about your father.
Gaston, you know he's not crazy.
I might be able to clear up this little misunderstanding if...
If what?
If you'll marry me.
What?
One little word, Belle. That's all it takes.
Never!
Have it your way. Take the old man!
Wait, no! I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast!
That's him!
Is he dangerous?
Oh no, he never hurt anyone. I know he looks frightful, but he's really kind and gentle. He's my friend.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say you have feelings for this monster.
He's not the monster, Gaston. You are.
She's as crazy as you own. Old man, she says this beast can be her friend. Well, I've hunted wild beasts, and I've seen what they can do. The beast will make all of your children in the night. He'll come after them.
He would never do that.
Forget the old man. I say we kill the beast.
We're not safe until he's dead. He'll come stalking us at night.
Set to sacrifice our child into his flesh.
He'll rehab a gun or village if we let him wander free.
So it's time to take some action, boys. It's time to follow me. Through the woods, through the mist, through the darkness and the shadows. It's a nightmare, but it's one exciting ride. Say a prayer, then we're there at the drawbridge of the castle, and there's something truly terrible inside. He's a beast, he's got fangs, razor sharp ones, massive paws, killer claws for the beast. Hear him roar, see him foam, but we're not coming home till he's dead. Good and dead! Kill the beast!
I won't let you do this.
Try and stop us.
Oh, Papa, this is all my fault. I have to go back and warn him.
I'm coming with you.
No!
I lost you once, and I'm not going to lose you again.
We'll rid the village of this beast. Who's with me?
I am!
Hearts of things, better time. We go marching into battle. On a freedom of the danger just increase. Raise a flag, sing a song. You can come 50 strong, and 50 freshmen can be wrong.
Kill the beast! Kill the beast! Kill the beast!
Kill
The angry mob of villagers marched through the forest, waving torches and weapons.
Once gathered in front of the beast castle, they carefully made their way inside.
Gaston, this place gives me the creeps.
Who was that young man?
The prince!
No, it wasn't. It most certainly was!
Yoo-hoo, bonjour, handsome.
Babette, you look so much better.
Oh, Lumiere, I like you this way better, too.
Well, madame, you look ravishing.
Thank you, Kaiser. I simply can't believe this gown fits me again after all these years.
Mama, Mama!
Chip, my boy, my boy.
Are they going to live happily ever after?
Of course, my dear, of course.
You still have to sleep in the cupboard.